Have you heard the term greenhouse gases? Let's break it down. First, let's talk about greenhouses. You know those glass buildings that are used to grow plants? Those glass walls trap the sun's heat, so plants can stay warm, even in the winter. That's pretty much what greenhouse gases do for Earth. They're actually a natural part of the Earth's atmosphere. Think of greenhouse gases like a blanket. They wrap around our planet, keeping it warm so that we can live on it. But hear me out. You've heard Goldilocks, right? It can't be too hot or too cold. The conditions have to be just right. Because of human activities in the last century, there are more greenhouse gases being released into the atmosphere, disrupting the balance. And that means more heat is getting trapped near the Earth's surface, causing temperatures to rise. And yes, you guessed it, the unusual increase of the Earth's surface temperature is called global warming. So, what exactly are the greenhouse gases in the atmosphere anyway? Well, let's break down five main types. First, carbon dioxide. It's the greenhouse gas with the biggest total impact on climate change. Most of the CO2 in the atmosphere has come from burning fossil fuels, so coal, gas, and oil. And then we have methane. It's released when fossil fuels are extracted from the earth, but it's also released by livestock, like cows. Next up is nitrous oxide. This gas can be released during industrial activities and from burning fossil fuels or solid waste. Then, we've got fluorinated gases. There are different kinds, but the ones you might be most familiar with are in your fridge. It's used to keep things cool. And finally, water vapor. Okay, water vapor isn't the main cause of global warming, but it is an effect and contributor to it. Because of global warming, more water evaporates, so more water goes into the atmosphere, trapping even more heat near the Earth's surface. And the cycle continues. Depending on the type, greenhouse gases can stay in the atmosphere for a few years or even for thousands of years. You're probably wondering, what are some of the effects of these greenhouse gases? Well, when the Earth's temperature rises, that can cause more frequent and intense heat waves, droughts, and floods. The extra CO2 is also changing the ocean's chemistry, affecting marine animals and making it harder for them to survive. But there are ways to prevent things from getting worse. Head to cbckidsnews.ca for those details.